If you would like to analyze the Toastmasters dashboard data without going to the Toastmasters website, then this video is for you. Let's get started. When we want to analyze the dashboard, we will go to the Leadership Central and the Distinguished Performance Reports. Most of these reports can be easily downloaded by clicking on the export button and selecting the CSV option, which is called a comma separated value file, which can be easily read in Excel. If we select a district, let's select district 20. I can select the district performance and then select export and download that as a CSV file. Or I can select the division and area performance and download that also as a CSV file. Finally, I can click on the club performance, which is about the DCP goals of each club in the district. For that report too, I can click on the export button and click CSV option. Once the file is downloaded, I click on it and it will open all the data in Excel, where I can do all kinds of analysis such as slice and dice, some kind of pivot tables, graphs, and so on. The only problem with this approach is that every time you want to do the analysis, you have to download the files all over again and start your analysis from scratch. What if there was a way I could open Excel file, type in a command, and it will bring me all the data without me having to download the file and then upload the file in Excel? Well, it turns out you can do that. Here are the four main commands to download the main Toastmaster dashboard: the district performance, the division performance, and the club level performance. You can download the file with all these commands from the link in the video description. You may ask me, from where did I get these commands? That is a topic for another video using a tool called Network Monitor. For now, let's assume that we want to use these commands to directly load the data from the Toastmasters website in an Excel file. Open your Excel, go to Data and select From Web. This is where you'll type one of the four commands. Let's say I want to analyze the club performance of the district. Let me take this script. I will select it, Control C, go to Excel, type that code here. The way you should interpret this script is as follows. This part represents the district. In my case, I'm downloading for 20. You can change it to any district of your choice. This represents the date of the report. In this case, it is set to 31st May 2021, the month end of May. And finally, this represents the term 2020-2021. Once you're satisfied, click on the OK button and voila, all the data is loaded directly in Excel. We need to do a few more things. Click on Transform Data. This report has one line at the end, which I don't want. Scroll down and select this row. Next, select on Remove Rows and choose Remove Bottom Rows. In my case, I want to remove just one row. So type 1 and select OK. Now my report is without that last line. Once you're satisfied, click on Close and Load. And now we have an Excel file with the latest data from the dashboard without actually going to the dashboard. From here, you can do all the normal activities such as pivot tables, make a graph, summarize, total. But the cool thing is, every time you want the latest data, all you have to do is click on Data, Refresh, and select Refresh All. And that's all there is to it. Your data is always up to date. In fact, if you want to make sure that every time you open this Excel file, you have the latest data, you can do one more thing, which is select on the Refresh option and select Connection Properties. Enable this option, which says Refresh Data when opening the file. Click OK and you're done. If you want all the four dashboards in a single Excel file, open a new sheet, select Data from the Web. Let's say you want the district performance, select the script from the file, Control C, come to Excel and paste it here. Check the parameters for the district and the date. Click OK. Click Transform Data. Check if there are any rows to be removed from the bottom. Yes, we do have one row that needs to be eliminated. Select remove rows, remove bottom rows, type one row to be removed, click OK, close and load, and you have your second dashboard. And you can keep doing it for the rest of the dashboards. In fact, any file that can be publicly downloaded as a CSV file, this is the easiest way to get the data into Excel. If you want to change the data for a new period, for example, a new month or a new year, all you have to do is click on the query, click edit. Next, click on this option, data source settings. Next, click on this button, change source. In this column, the URL, you can now change the parameters, for example, for a different district or a different month. Let's say I want the data to be refreshed as of end of June. Change this 5 to 6, 30th of June, and click OK. Next, click close, close and load, and your data is now refreshed for June. I hope you found this short tutorial useful. Have fun playing with the dashboards.